Dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel, Vidya for Success. Yes, children, welcome to today's session. Yes, so far in this lesson, we discussed about animal breeding and also we discussed about animal husbandry. And there we understood one thing, that use of good breed in the farm will always give more productivity. That means productivity can be increased by the use of good breed, right? So that is just one part of this lesson. And on the another part, we are proceeding with one more very important concept, that is plant breeding. So why plant breeding? Is there any need of breeding plants? Yes, let us study about that here. So children, if you take any ecosystem, in the ecosystem, plants are very important because they occupy the base of the ecosystem, because they are the main producers. So all other living organisms in the ecosystem directly or indirectly depends on plants for food. Around 80% of the food what we are consuming, that is directly coming from plant, right? So when there is a more demand, obviously we need to increase the productivity, right? So if you see in one ant, a population is keep on increasing, and on the another ant, we can't increase the agricultural land, right? We can't increase the agricultural land because not all lands are suitable for agriculture. So within the available agriculture land, we have to increase the productivity. How it is possible? Is it possible only with the help of traditional farming? No, right? So by the traditional farming, just a limited biomass can be obtained. So that is only sufficient for the human beings and some other animals. Like when we are not taking a better way of farming, it is not possible to increase the biomass, right? Is it possible by the proper management of crop? By the proper management of crop, can we reach the expected biomass? No, that is also not possible. We can extend only to a limited this thing. Beyond that, it is not possible, right? So for increasing the biomass for a large extent, we should use a better crop variety. So when we use the better crop variety within the limited, that means within the available agricultural land, we can get the more productivity, we can increase the biomass, right? So how to raise the better plant variety? That is possible by different techniques of plant breeding. So there are some techniques are there in the plant breeding. So by using those techniques, it is possible to raise the high yield giving varieties or disease resistant varieties. So the desirable plants can be raised by the different techniques of plant breedings, right? So when we started using the good variety of plant in the crop plant, we got a increased biomass. So here in the 1960, by the implementation of new techniques of plant breeding, so we have seen a drastic increase in the biomass production, right? So different techniques of plant breeding were implemented in the year 1960. So not only in our India, all over the world, we have seen a drastic increase in the biomass production coming from the plant. So that rapid increase in the productivity from the plant is called as Green Revolution. So how this revolution was possible? It was possible because of the use of good plant variety. So good plant variety can be raised by one of the technique called as plant breeding, right? So let us now study about plant breeding. So what do you mean by plant breeding? So how can we define the plant breeding? So plant breeding is a purposeful manipulation of plant species in order to create desired plant type. So the our purpose in the plant breeding is raising the desired trait, right? So for raising the desired plant type, we are manipulating the plant species. We are making some changes in the plant in order to raise the desired plant. So that method is known as plant breeding. So is it possible to manipulate the plant species? Yes, let me take the example for this. So we want to raise the tall hibiscus plant with pink flower. So this is our desirable trait in the plant, right? So for raising the desired plant, we have to select appropriate parent, right? So the first parent what we were selected here is the short plant, hibiscus plant with red flower. And the second parent selected is tall hibiscus plant with white flower. So by crossing those two parents, it is possible to raise the desired plant. So what was our desired trait should be in the hibiscus plant? So tall plant with pink flower, right? So by selecting the appropriate parent, we can raise the desired plant. So that is what called as manipulation. That means we are manipulating which desirable character we are expecting in the progeny. So with respect to that, we are selecting the parent. So that is called as manipulation, right? So by the manipulation, by the purposeful manipulation of plant species, we are raising the desired plant type. That method of raising the desired plant type is called as plant breeding. Understood? So it is possible to raise the better suited cultivar by the plant breeding, right? So by the plant breeding technique, it is possible to develop better yield giving plants. So this is one desirable character, right? So always the farmer expect a better yield from the crop plant. Understood? So not all plants give a better yield. So by the plant breeding method, it is possible to raise the crop with better yield giving ability. That means that the plant is inbuilt with the better yield giving ability. So by plant breeding, by purposeful manipulation, it is possible to raise the high yield giving crop varieties, and also it is possible to raise the disease resistant varieties. So these are the desired trait we are expecting to be there in the crop plant. So those characters can be seen in the plant when we raise them by the plant breeding. So what thing we have to do is we have to select appropriate parent in order to raise the desired progeny. Clear? So that method is known as plant breeding. Yes, here we have a list of desired traits that the breeders have tried to incorporate into crop plants. Because from the crop plants, the farmers are expecting always more yield, right? And that is a most preferable trait should be there in the crop plant. So the crop should be high yield giving plant. And the one more desired trait should be there in the crop plant is improved quality. So when the quality of product is good, the marketing value always more, right? So the improved quality is one more desired trait should be there in the crop. Then increased tolerance to stress. So not all plants can sustain in stressful condition like a drought and salinity. So what do you mean by salinity? Salinity is nothing but high salt concentration in the soil. So in such a condition, plants cannot survive. So when the plants are not able to survive, the yield will be drastically reduces. So that one of the desired trait they are trying to incorporate into the plant is tolerance to stress. So when they are able to tolerate the stressful environmental condition, the yield can be expected. So that they are trying to incorporate this trait in the crop plant. And resistant to pathogen. So this is very important, because most of the crops, they are attacked by the pathogens. So when they are attacked by the pathogen, the yield is get decreases, right? So when they are inborn with the resistant to pathogen, they are not attacked by the pathogen, so that we can expect the good yield. So this is the one more trait expected in the crop plant. Then a last one is tolerance to insect. So insect tolerance is very important, because most of the insects, they come and eat different part of the plant. Sometimes they eat a flower, leaf and stem. So like this, when the plants are inborn with the tolerance to insect, they are not attacked by the insect, right? The crop will be of good condition and the yield also get increased. So these are the some set of desired trait the breeders have tried to incorporate into the crop plant in order to increase the biomass. Yes, let us move to the very important concept of plant breeding, that is steps in breeding a new genetic variety of a crop. So here we are studying what are the steps involved in the plant breeding, right? So in order to study this step, first you have to understand the plant breeding. So what is the purpose of plant breeding? So the purpose is to get a desired plantlet by the purposeful manipulation of plant species. Understood? And also you have to keep in your mind the example what I gave you when explaining the plant breeding, right? So the first step of the plant breeding is collection of variability. So variability is nothing but variety. So you take any species of plant, in each of the species we have different varieties. So all varieties of plant belong to a particular species must be collected. That is the first step, right? So the collection and preservation of all the different wild varieties, species and relatives of a cultivated species. So I'll take the example here. So you take ragi plant. So ragi plant is a one species. It belong, all ragi plants are belong to one species. So within one species we can see different varieties. So some ragi plants are disease resistant, some ragi plants grow very well in drought, and some ragi plants they are tall, some are dwarf. Like this, different varieties of ragi plants are available, right? So each of the varieties are different in their characteristic feature. So some are wild varieties, clear, and some are domesticated species. So like this, all varieties, whatever the varieties are available, all the varieties must be collected, whether it may be a wild variety or it may be a cultivated species. So all plants must be collected first, right? So what is the purpose of this collection? So when we are collecting different variety, that means that we are collecting all the alleles for all the genes, all the possible alleles for all the genes we are collecting. Clear? So we have a place where the collection of diverse allele for all the gene in a given crop is present. So that is called as germplasm collection. Right? This is very important. Germplasm collection is nothing but it is the entire collection of all diverse allele for all the genes in a given crop. So this is the main purpose, right? So gene is responsible for expressing each and every character in the organism, right? So when we are collecting different varieties of plant, it means that we are collecting all the alleles for all the genes in a given crop. So that is called as germplasm collection, right? So after this, after the collection of variability, so the second step is evaluation and selection of parents, right? So among the collected plants, among the collected varieties, so we are searching for a parent. So the searching of parents depends on our desirable plant, which desired plant we want to get from the parent. So with respect to that, we are searching the parents here, right? So evaluation and selection of parents is the next step. So the germplasm is evaluated to select plants with desirable combination of character. So which character we are expecting to be in the progeny? So with similar to that character, we are searching the parent in the germplasm collection. So what we have to do is we have to evaluate the germplasm in order to select the parent plant. Understood? And the selected plants, parents, are self-pollinated in order to raise the pure lines. So this is very important here. So after the selection of parents, we have to raise the pure lines by self-pollinating, right? So we have selected two parents means, so in both the parents, we have to do the self-pollination and we have to raise the pure lines. So this is the second step. And yes, the third step is cross-hybridization among selected parents. So what do you mean by this cross-hybridization? Say for example, we have selected two parents. You consider first parent as a A and second parent as a B. So in cross-hybridization, first what they will do is they will collect the pollen grain from the A parent and they transfer on to the stigma of B parent, right? So this pollination is called as cross-pollination. So cross-pollination is the first step of hybridization process. So after cross-pollination, they will bag the cross-pollinated flower in order to protect from unwanted pollen grains, right? So the bag is left as it is in the pollinated flower until the formation of seeds, right? So the seeds formed as a result of cross-pollination are sown in the soil in order to raise the progeny. Understood? So all the progeny obtained as a result of cross-pollination are called as hybrid progeny. So why they are called as hybrid progeny? Because they are obtained as a result of cross-pollination. So because of that, they are called as hybrid. Understood? So this genetically combine the desired character in one plant. Right? So because of the cross-pollination, we are combining the desired character in one plant. Suppose the first parent, the A parent, is rich in protein content and the B parent is disease resistant. So as a result of cross-pollination, cross-hybridization, so we can see the both character in the single plant. That means the hybrid progeny, what is obtained, that is showing the combination of both the character. So this is the purpose of cross-hybridization. So why we are doing the cross-hybridization means our object is to see the both the character in the same plant so that we are crossing the selected parents. So this help in the combining the genetic character, desired character in one plant, right? So after this, after cross-hybridization, the next step is selection and testing of superior recombinant, right? So selection and testing of superior recombinant. So some hundred seeds are obtained after cross-hybridization, right? So you have sown all the 100 seeds. Among 100 seeds, only 3 or 4 plants are hybrid plants. You can't expect that all the plants are hybrid, right? So only 3 or 4 plants will be hybrid plant. Understood? So we have to select the hybrid plant, that means the superior recombinant we are selecting from the progeny. So that is the fourth step. So after the selection of superior recombinant, these are self-pollinated for several generation. So what they will do is continuously they will do the self-pollination among the selected superior recombinant. So, as I told, three or four plants will be superior hybrids. Like so those plants were selected and they were self-pollinated continuously for several generation. Clear? So this self-pollination will be continued till it reaches the state of uniformity. That means until the formation of uniform type of plants, they will self-pollinate among the selected hybrid. So this will help in the rising of superior recombinant, so that all obtained superior recombinants are same type. That means homozygote plants were raised after the selection. Understood? So this is the fourth step. So as a result of the self-pollination, so we have raised the homozygous plants. So all the progeny, hybrid progeny obtained are the same type. So what is the last step? So the last and important step is testing, release and commercialization of new cultivars. So in the fourth step, we have seen that hybrid pure lines were raised, right? So those pure lines were in the next step sent for the testing. So where they will do the testing? So testing actually done in the research field. So all the hybrid plants were grown in the research field and they are tested for yield and different agronomic trait quality, then disease resistance. And these are actually tested by giving them fertilizer and irrigation, then under other crop management practices, right? So while testing, they will record the result, whether they are suitable or not. All these things are actually recorded. And after completion of testing in the research field, they again sent to the farmer's field. Clear? So in different locations, the hybrid plants were grown in the country and they are actually tested for at least three growing seasons. Suppose in our country, so we have raised one hybrid plant means, so we try to grow the hybrid plant in different location of our country. So some they are sent to the north region, some they are sent to the west, some they are to the east. So like this, in different location, the hybrid plants are actually tested. Clear? So after testing in the farmer's land, they compare the hybrid seeds with the already existing seeds of that particular locality. So if the hybrid seed seems to be best compared to the existing crop, then the hybrid seed is sent for the commercialization. That means they will multiply the hybrid seed and those are sent for the commercialization. Clear? So that newly raised hybrid plant is known as new cultivars. Clear? This is very important. New cultivars is nothing but selected hybrid plant. Clear? So this is the last step of plant breeding. So by these followed five step, finally the new cultivars raised. Clear? So these are the very important steps of plant breeding method. So I hope you understood this concept. So please go through this video and practice all the steps of plant breeding, because this is very important concept for the point of examination, right? Thank you.